In February, 53% said that they agreed to that statement that the elections would be clean and credible. In March, it was only 47%. Then the biggest lapse was seen in the NCR, the National Capital Region. It used to be 53, now it's just 35. And this is prospective, right? If you're getting these numbers now, after the elections, with all of the reports about what transpired, right. I'm pretty sure that these numbers will drastically change. That you'll have more people perceiving that the elections were not clean and credible, despite the automated counting. We heard it in the workshop on money politics when Louis Guia was talking about this Supreme Court decision, and I've checked again with Comelec. And I know survey data shows that voters go to the precincts, 60% of the voters go to the precinct from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. You have 600 on the average voters in each district. And there are several things that you have to do. Register, get the ballot, shade your choices, fill the ballot, press the button, and then get your receipt. And 60% go to the precincts within the first 3 hours after the precincts open. And those will be reported in media. So just imagine if the problems, many of those problems will be reported and it gets to a level which is quite frequent, how would that affect public's perception about the conduct of the election? And how would that impact eventually on the acceptability and credibility of the results? So I'm sure that these numbers will change. Everyone is suspect.
Yes.
Right.
It's a thing that I've seen, at least, like my avoidance social media. It's very tight. I mean, this is just a chart, and this is just a national chart. You may say that Dina is sliding, but the slide is not significant. Mars is flat, Grace is flat, and Duterte might be incrementally moving up, but the slope is not also quite significant. But the movement of Duterte in the last three survey observations have been going up, basically. So whether that will sustain, and there was one survey that was published by the Standard poll by Juni, where Duterte and Grace are statistically tied, but Duterte is arithmetically ahead. So that might be the case, but one thing that you should remember is that all of the top contenders have not kept their post after one.
Other candidates will pounce on the person who's
it
on top.
Is still 30 days before the election. Many things can happen. Yeah, that's why that's a challenge for that machine. You have to track who are the ones defecting.
Yeah.
And then eventually, the last formal alliance, you have to check what has happened on the ground. And I know, I've been trying to get it from all of the groups, but they've not given it to me because I think what is happening in most of these groups is what has happened in the past. The work of operating those machines is very much compartmentalized. There's not a single person on top who knows all the areas.
Yeah.
Or even if there's a person on top who knows all the areas, that person would be out.
Because the survey results were not disseminated. I put it in the contact, no dissemination. I get any text message that disseminates it,
you have to pay double the price. And I just gave one copy to the principal and asked everyone to bring down their cell phones, no picture taking, no recording. Meaning was ahead in a survey that was conducted in the last week of April after the result of May. We have not seen any firmness in terms of who the primary contenders are. We saw Poet Binay leading the pack in the past. But that has changed to the extent that right now it's really Ho and Duterte. In the vice presidential race, we saw Cheese and Bongbong. Then it has changed to Bongbong Cheese. Then now Lenny's closing in. So the combatants are changing. Here, I'll show you just one slide.
Why is Duterte catching up?
Not because of Mindanao, not because of Visayas. This is Central Visayas. He's going to hold. He has killed down. Mar is going up. It is largely because of getting support from Calabarzon, which is 14% of the total votes. Look at Duterte from 8.7 to 14.3 to 18.9.
And that's not the only. Wait, there's more.
NCR.
Central Luzon. No, NCR has always been strong. Where he has 10.7 and goes up to 19. That's 11% of the total voting population. If he continues to move up in those with the dominance that he shows in three of the five regions in Mindanao, even if he gives up Central Visayas, which is the Cebuano and the linguistic tie that he has, so, yun, that's the reason. That's the other thing that we're checking. If Duterte appears to move up from fourth second choice to second choice, then.
Tapos na.
But yes, na.